उतना वॉल्यूम चेंज होगा। ओके, स्ट्रेन यू नो, स्ट्रेस यू नो, राइट? स्ट्रेस इज मीन्स फोर्स ऑफ रेजिस्टेंस पर यूनिट एरिया, स्ट्रेन इज द चेंज इन डायमेंशन पर यूनिट डायमेंशन, पर द ओरिजिनल डायमेंशन। ओके, सो दैट इज कॉल्ड एज स्ट्रेन। ओके, स्ट्रेन मीन्स चेंज इन डायमेंशन ऑफ अ कंपोनेंट। ओके, so here it happens in fluid also. Whenever there is a compressive stress acting on the fluid, it will change its volume. Okay, so that is increase in pressure or volumetric change. For an example, if we consider this is a piston cylinder arrangement, okay, so in this I have put some fluid, we can take gas. Okay, I have added gas in this. Okay, now I'm applying some pressure on this. So the beginning, the pressure will be volume V. Sorry, the volume will be volume V. Okay, now when I apply a pressure on this piston, what will happen? It will compress the fluid. So the piston will come at this point. So I'll just make it with a different some. Piston will come this side. Okay, till this point. So what has happened? The volume has changed between these two, that is delta V. The change in volume is delta V. Okay, or we can say dV. Okay, this is the change in volume to the original volume. To the original volume. So what is happening is whenever I go on increasing the pressure, so if we consider this to be a, this is not, if you consider this to be in 3D dimension, what it will be like this. Right? Something like this. Okay, so whenever I apply a pressure on this, what will happen? It will go on compressing the fluid which is there inside this piston cylinder arrangement. Okay, so what will happen when I go on compressing the pressure, when I go on compressing or when I go on applying the force of pressure, what will happen? The volume or whatever volume is there of the air or the volume of the liquid will go on decreasing. Okay, so therefore there is a volumetric strain. So the volume is going on decreasing in the form of length, right? Is going in form of length because I am decreasing it using length, right? In the form of length. But what is happening is there is breadth and there is some height because it is not a, it is not in a single plane. It is in a triple plane, that is three dimension. Okay, if you imagine it to be three dimension. So that's why we are calling it as volumetric strain. So volumetric is L, B and H, so meter cube. The length, in the terms of length, we are decreasing the pressure. Okay, in this length, in this way, but B and H are also getting decreased. Sorry, B and H will remain constant, but B, L will be changing because of which we are changing the volume when we are applying the pressure. Okay. Any doubts? Any doubts? So we have to find the equation for bulk modulus. Okay, then we can say that compressibility is 1 by bulk modulus of elasticity. Any doubts till now? I hope you don't have any doubt. So next part is what? So as I've shown you the same with the same diagram, that whenever I am applying the pressure P on the piston, using the piston on the gas or the liquid or fluid which is present inside the cylinder piston arrangement, so what is happening, it is compressing the fluid. Okay, so when it, there is compression, the piston will move to this end, to this end, so therefore there is a change in pressure. At this point the pressure was different, at this point the pressure increases, right? Therefore there is an increase in pressure. But what happened to volume? Volume got decreased. The volume decreases. Therefore, when we apply the pressure, the volume goes on decreasing. Okay, then as shown in the above figure, consider a cylinder fitted with the piston. Let volume of a gas enclosed in the cylinder. What is the volume of the gas? V is the volume of the gas, and P is the pressure of the gas when the volume is V. Okay, when the volume is V, the P is the pressure. Let the pressure is increased from P to P plus dP. When I increase the pressure from P to P plus dP, that is the change in pressure. This is the change in pressure. So now the pressure is increased. Then the volume of the gas decreases. Obviously, when I press it, what will happen? It will lower the volume inside this cylinder. Okay. Therefore, the volume decreases from V to V minus dV. Therefore, the increase in pressure will be what? dP. Right. The increase in pressure will be dP. The decrease in volume will be dV. Right. So I have increased the pressure by dP pressure and decrease the volume by dV pressure. So what will be the volumetric strain now? Volumetric strain is minus dV by V. So it means that volumetric strain is change in volume divided by original volume. Change in volume divided by original volume. Change in volume divided by original volume. Therefore, that is the decrease in what? That is nothing but volumetric strain. So why we are indicating with it a negative sign? Because when the as the pressure increases, the volume goes on decreasing. Therefore, we are indicating it with a negative sign. So what will be the formula now? So what is bulk modulus? As we have discussed in the previous definition, it is the compressive stress, that is the increase in pressure divided by the volumetric strain. So what is the increasing pressure? dP. What is the volumetric strain? Minus dV by V. Therefore, it will be minus V dP by dV. So K is equal to what? Minus V dP by dV, where V is the volume of the gas inside the cylinder, dP is the increase in pressure, and dV is the change in volume. Any doubts till now? If you are not understood, I'll repeat it again for you. Okay, fine. Any doubts?
So one second, sir.
Okay. So we are going to define another property for a fluid, that is compressibility and bulk modulus. Okay. So we define compressibility as reciprocal of bulk modulus of elasticity. That is 1 by bulk modulus of elasticity. So reciprocal means 1 by something. Okay. So 1 by K is the compressibility. As I have told, there are two types. We can compress the fluid. Okay. So for liquid, we generally say it is an incompressible fluid. Incompressible fluid. But a gas is a compressible fluid. So we want to check at what extent I can compress the fluid. Okay. So therefore, we are going for these two parameters, that is compressibility and bulk modulus. To know compressibility, we should know what is the bulk modulus of elasticity, K. Okay, so compressibility is nothing but the reciprocal of bulk modulus of elasticity. Now, we got to know what is compressibility. To know that, we need to know what is meant by K. To know the K, the definition is like this. It is defined as compressive stress to the volumetric strain. So for an example, okay, this is something, this is a cube, okay. Have you seen jellies? Jellies. So whenever you apply pressure on this, what will happen? It will reduce its volume, or it will reduce its size. Same way, I'm applying the pressure on a fluid layer, or you can say fluid element. Okay. So this fluid element will go on reducing its volume. Okay. It's like jelly, right? So jelly will regain its shape after you remove the space, remove the force. But when you press the jelly, what will happen? It will go for a change in volume, right? So you might have seen some kind of rubbers or some jelly things which you can press it and you can change its shape, right? Right. So same way, like that, we are applying the compressive force on the element of a fluid. Just imagine that the element of a fluid, then its volume is going on decreasing. So for that, I have given an example, like if there is a cylinder and there is a piston to it, okay, and there is gas filled in this completely. So at this point, the pressure is somewhat P. Okay. Now what I will do is that I will apply some more pressure to it, like this. So when I press this, so what will apply? It will apply some more pressure and the piston will come here. So what has happened? I have increased the pressure from P to P plus dP. I applied extra pressure dP, change in pressure. Okay. Now, so what has happened to the volume? It got decreased from this point to this point. So there is a change in volume, that is delta V, or we say dV. Okay. So what happens is that when we apply a pressure, when we increase the pressure, then what will happen? There is a chances of volumetric strain. Strain is change in dimension. You know that when we apply a stress, there will be a change, a strain, right? So that strain is given by volumetric strain. So we are taking lateral strain, longitudinal strain, and this is volumetric strain. So total volume is getting changed here. Okay, there's a change in dimension of the volume through volumetric this one. Okay, now. So we have derived an expression which tells the relation between, which gives the relationship of bulk modulus. So bulk modulus, we have said, increase in pressure divided by volumetric strain. Volumetric strain. So I have written it. Increase in pressure divided by volumetric strain. So as shown in the figure, that let the V be the volume of the gas enclosed inside the cylinder. Okay. Let P be the pressure of gas when the volume is V. So when the volume is V, actual volume is V, then the pressure is P. Okay. When I increase the pressure from P to P plus dP, what happened? So it means that I have changed the pressure to dP. So what happened? The volume changed from V to V minus dV. So volume decreased. So it came here. How much is the change? Sorry. It came here. How much is the change? Delta V is the change, or dV is the change. Okay, so V minus dV. Then if I increase the, then what happens is, what is here? Increase in pressure. What is increase in pressure? dP. I have increased by dP. What is decrease in volume? dV. What is volumetric strain? So volumetric strain, I have told you. What is volumetric strain? The volumetric strain is change in volume divided by the original volume. Change in volume divided by original volume. So what is the change in volume? This is, what is the original volume? Original volume is the when before applying the pressure on the fluid. That is the original volume. Okay. Now, so this is written as negative because when we apply the increase the pressure, the volume is going on decreasing. That's why we are applying the negative sign. Therefore, when we say that, we have to substitute everything in this. So K is nothing but increase in pressure divided by volumetric strain. So K equal to dP divided by dV by V. Therefore, minus V dP by D. This is the formula for what? Compressibility. Okay. Sorry, this is the formula for bulk modulus. Now, so compressibility is what? 1 by K. So how you'll write this? 1 by dP by dV by V. Right? Right or no? How can you write that now? So V by VdV dP is nothing but your compressibility. So you just write 1 by K, so you'll get the answer. So in most of the problem, they will be asking you how to determine the bulk modulus of elasticity. Okay, fine. Any doubts you have? Okay. So based on this, okay. Based on this, we are going to derive another two expression for a gas, for isothermal process, and for one more is for adiabatic process. Okay. So for that, we are going to determine the relationship between the bulk modulus and pressure P for a gas. Okay. That is, for first one is isothermal process, where we are going to determine the K, that is the bulk modulus, and the pressure. Okay, so what is isothermal process? What is isothermal process?
Temperature
is constant. Very good. So temperature is constant. Very good. Temperature constant. Therefore, PV equal to RT R is constant, T is constant, therefore PV equal to constant. So PV equal to constant. So differentiating this equation, what we get? I will differentiate it. P TV plus V DP equal to zero. Get differentiated. Then after differentiating, we are getting P DV equal to minus V DP. We're taking this minus V DP here. Okay. Therefore, P equal to what? Minus DP divided by DV into V. Minus DP divided by V into V. So what is this? That is nothing but the bulk modulus. I've written K equal to what in the previous definition we have K taken? Minus V DP by DV. So K is nothing but minus V DP by DV. Okay. So this is P equal to somewhat K. So for adiabatic, for isothermal process, the pressure is equal to the bulk modulus. Okay. The pressure is equal to the bulk modulus. So this is for a gas. Now,
Excuse me, sir.
Okay, the next part is, tell me.
Sir, why did you differentiate P into DV and V into DP?
Because I'm differentiating P with respect to V and V with respect to P.
Okay, sir.
Okay, so this is the way we are getting an expression for the isothermal process for a relationship between K and P. Okay. The next one is for an adiabatic process. For an adiabatic process, PV raised to gamma equal to constant. Okay. PV raised to gamma equal to constant, where gamma is the adiabatic index. Okay. Where now what happens is I'm going to differentiate it again. So it is V raised to gamma, X raised to N. So N is nothing but X raised to N minus 1. Differentiate if you differentiate it. X raised to n is n raised to n into x raised to n minus 1. In the same way, T as it is, okay, I'm differentiating P, keeping P as it is, I'm differentiating V. Here I'm differentiating P, okay. Now, P into gamma, okay, P into gamma into V raised to gamma minus 1 because x raised to n minus 1. So V raised to gamma minus 1 into DV plus V raised to gamma DP equal to 0. Okay, now, so what I'll do, P into gamma, V raised to gamma into V raised to minus 1, I've separated here. So I've done it like this, V raised to gamma minus 1. So V raised to gamma into V raised to minus 1. So this will be gamma minus 1 itself, V raised to gamma minus 1 DV. Okay, now, V raised to gamma, I'll take it outside. You can say V raised to gamma and this V raised to gamma, I'll take it outside. So what will remain? P into gamma V raised to minus 1 DV plus DP equal to 0. Okay. Now, what will remain here? P into gamma into 1 by V DV. V raised to minus 1, na? So what will it will become? V raised to gamma I have taken outside. So P into gamma into V raised to minus 1 DV plus DP equal to 0. Now, P into gamma, V raised to minus 1 is 1 by V DV plus DP equal to 0. Now, this V is equal to 0 if I cross multiply. So this V will go, okay? How it will go means, see here. P into gamma 1 by V DV plus DP here equal to 0, okay? So what I'm going to do is P gamma into DV plus VDP. If I take an LCM of it, VDP equal to 0. So this V will become like this. This V will become completely or hold this and V will be multiplied over here. So P into gamma into 1 by VDV plus VDP equal to 0. So V will go here and it will become 0. Okay. So what will remain? P into gamma into DV plus VDP. Okay. So we will take this will take on the left side, that is the right hand side. So P into gamma into DV equal to minus VDP. So we get P into gamma equal to minus VDP by DV. So what will happen? What will be remaining here? So what is the, this is what? K. So K equal to what? P into gamma equal to K. So this is completely K. Therefore, K equal to P into gamma. So here, in isothermal, K equal to P, and in adiabatic, K equal to P into gamma. That is adiabatic index. Okay. In some books, they take it as N. Okay. Right. Any doubts till now? So based on this, we are going to solve some problems. Only two simple problems are there. Okay. So I want you people to note down this formula. What is P? Change in pressure, increase in pressure, sorry. What is V? dV, change in, decrease in volume, and volumetric strain. You remember this three. And remember this formula, K equal to minus V dP by T. Okay. You remember this formula, we'll solve some problems. Note it down first. Can anyone tell me the unit for this? What may be the unit for this? For K, compressibility, sorry, bulk modulus. Anyone of you fast?
Newtons per meter square. Sir.
Newton per meter square. Newton per meter square. Is this right? Anyone else?
Newton per mm square.
Okay, if it is given in centimeter, then it is centimeter. If given in meter, then it is meter. There is no change in that. Okay, correct. It is Newton per meter square. Why? Because this is pressure. Newton per meter square, dV by V will be meter cube by meter cube. So it will be a dimensionless quantity. Volumetric strain is a dimensionless quantity. Therefore, an unitless quantity. Therefore, the remaining unit is Newton per meter square. So the unit of K is Newton per meter square. Okay. Now, I hope you have noted down the formula. So we'll go to the problems now.
Yes, sir.
Okay. What is the question over here? Can you tell me? Okay. So what the question is, that determine the bulk modulus of elasticity, that is K, of a fluid which is compressed inside a cylinder from the volume of 0.009 meter cube at 70 Newton per centimeter square pressure to a volume of 0.0085 meter cube at 270 Newton per centimeter square pressure. So what you have to find out? You have to find out the bulk modulus of elasticity. The formula is what? V minus dP by dV. Can anyone calculate and let me know the answer? You try it once. I have given you the formula. You try it and let me know the answer in 5 minutes. Or you can take your time for 2 to 3 minutes. From what to what the pressure has changed? What is the increase in pressure? What is the increase in pressure?
70 to 270.
Okay, it has increased from, actually, see here. The cylinder volume, see, compressed. So see here, what is happening is we have compressed the cylinder from the volume of 0.09 meter cube to 0.0085 meter cube. So the volume has decreased. Okay. And there is an increase in pressure from 70 to 270. Therefore, increase in pressure is 270 minus 70. How much it is? 200 Newton per centimeter square. Okay, now Now what is there? Decrease in volume. What is decrease in volume? How will you calculate decrease in volume? The volume has decreased from 0.009 to 0.0085. What is the answer now for this? Pi into 10 raised to minus 4. Okay, I'll write meter cube for you. What I have to calculate? I have to calculate K. Okay, now I can write as increase in pressure divided by decrease in volume. No, because it is K is nothing but increase in pressure divided by volumetric strain. So what is the formula? I'll write like this for you. Dp divided by minus dv by v. Minus dv by v. Tell me the answer now. You'll get the answer. See, this negative sign, it only means that as the pressure increases, the volume decreases. But when you get the answer at the end, it doesn't mean that you have to use this negative sign. Okay, that is just signifies that when the pressure increases, the volume decreases. Now, what is dp? 200 divided by. What is dv? Decrease in volume. Pi into 10 raised to minus 4 divided by. What is the volume? Original volume kya tha? 70. Now get the answer for this. Tell me first. Good. 3600 Newton per centimeter square. Newton per centimeter square. Okay, correct? Most of you might have got the answer. Okay.
Sir, original volume 70. New.
Original volume is not 70. Sorry, correct. The original
sir,
volume
original
is not
70,
it is 0.00. Yeah, right. Sorry for that. Sorry. Okay. The original volume is 0.009. Okay, this is the original volume. Okay, now you have got the answer correct. That is 3600 Newton per centimeter square. Sorry for this. Okay, it is 0.009. But this is the way you have to find out. One more thing I have told you to forgot to tell you that this volumetric strain will be nothing but the percentage change in the volume. See, change in volume divided by original volume. Right? The change in volume divided by original volume is nothing but percentage change in the volume of that component or of that body. Okay. So in some problems, he may give like percentage change in the volume. Okay. So how to find out that, I'll tell you in the next problem. Okay, so we'll clear this. Any doubts in this problem?
No, sir.
No, you should not take minus because it is just showing that there is a decrease in volume. Okay, there it's just showing that it is decrease in volume. So generally what happens is, so decrease in or change in volume, we say it as 0.0085 minus 0.009. Okay, we change, we say in general it is change in volume 0.0085 to 0.009, but this answer will come in negative. This answer will come in negative. So to make it positive value, we are multiplying it with a negative sign. Therefore, we are getting the answer in a positive sign. That's why, not to confuse you like that, so I have told you that this negative sign is only meant for saying that the, as the pressure increases, the volume decreases. Okay, any other doubt? Okay, fine. So as one more thing, that this dV by V is a percentage change in the volume. Okay, so we'll get to know how it is in the next problem. So the pressure of the liquid, the pressure of the liquid is increased from 60 Newton per centimeter square to 100 Newton per centimeter square. Pressure is increased from 60 to 100. Okay, and the volume decreases by 2%, 0.2%, and the volume decreases by 0.2%. Determine the bulk modulus of elasticity. Determine the bulk modulus of elasticity. Now, how to calculate this? What is the initial pressure?
60.
60. Initial pressure is 60. What is the final pressure? That is
100.
100 Newton per centimeter square. 60 Newton per centimeter square. Now, what is telling that the volume decreases by 0.2%. 0.2%. Good. So now, how can I find out the increase in pressure? What is the increase in pressure? Increase in pressure is 100 minus 60. Therefore, it is 40 Newton per Newton per centimeter square. Good. So what we have to determine? We have to determine the bulk modulus. K equal to minus V dP by dV. Right? Now, we don't know V and dV, right? It is just 0.2%. All right. So we can write this as dP by minus V by dV. Both are same. So as I have told, this percentage, 0.2% is nothing but percentage change in the volume. Sorry. Wait.
dV by V.
Wait. I'm writing that wrong. Sorry. Minus dV by V. So this minus dV change in volume to the original volume is percentage change in the volume. Therefore, we can write as change in pressure as 40 divided by percentage change is 0.2 divided by 100. If they give in percentage, just do it like this, 40 divided by 0.2, because this means that it is percentage change. Okay, percentage 0.2%. So 0.2% is 0.2 divided by 100. So what is the answer now?
Yes, sir.
20,000 Newton per centimeter square, or 2 into 10 to the 4 Newton per centimeter square. Okay, this is the answer. 2 into 10 to the 4 Newton per centimeter square, or 20,000 Newton per centimeter square. Okay, understood?
Yes, sir.
So this is the way you are changing it. Fine. Next. So the next topic is vapor pressure and cavitation. Vapor pressure and cavitation. This is a theory concept, but which is very useful in your turbo machine part. Vapor pressure and cavitation. So can anyone tell me what is meant by boiling? What is meant by boiling? Boiling means formation of bubbles. Formation of bubbles. Right. Formation of bubbles. Can anyone tell me what is the boiling point of water?
100.
Wrong. Wrong. You are an engineer, you should know boiling point of water.
100, sir.
Wrong. Wrong.
99.
Wrong. I'll tell you how you should tell if anyone asks you.
100
if a normal, if it is okay, fine. Listen. If I ask to any normal person who is not an engineer, he will tell 100 degrees Celsius. But you being an engineer, you should know what you should say. Okay, when you have been asked what is boiling point of water. So it is 100 degrees Celsius at what? Atmospheric pressure. At atmospheric pressure, that is 101325 Pascal or 101.325 kilopascal or 1 bar. Understand, remember this point. Huh?
Yes,
if you are an engineer, so you should know that the boiling point of water is 100 degrees Celsius at only atmospheric pressure. Okay. So if we go on increasing the pressure or if we go on decreasing the pressure, what will happen? If we go on increasing the pressure above the atmospheric pressure, then the boiling point of water also goes on increasing. If I come below the atmospheric pressure to boil the water, what will happen? The temperature for boiling of water will also go on decreasing. That's why whenever you go to a hilly area, okay, and if you go on cook, the food will be cooking at a faster rate. Why? Because the pressure is less. So the temperature required, the water will boil at a lower temperature. Below the 100 degrees Celsius. Even I can boil water at 60 degrees Celsius. Even I can boil water at 45 degrees Celsius. Even I can boil the water at 30 degrees Celsius. But when the pressure goes on decreasing. Can anyone tell me why? Why this is the phenomena? Like this. Why this is like it is like this? Can anyone tell me why it is like this? Because, see here. I'll just tell you a simple example. It is just for your knowledge. Because I have to go with the concept of vapor pressure. Now, when I go on hitting the water, what will happen? Let it be, leave it. We'll go with the vapor pressure. See here, vapor pressure. So what is vapor pressure? Now, I have a container in which I have filled it with water. Okay. And this water is at 25 degrees Celsius. It is at 25 degrees Celsius. And upon this water, atmospheric pressure is acting. Because it is on Earth, atmospheric pressure is acting on every one of us on the surface. Okay, that is 101325 kilo, sorry, Pascal, only Pascal. Okay, that is 1 bar. Or 760 mm of Hg. Now my question is, there will be water droplets which is at the surface. It will be trying to come out. Because it is trying to vaporize from the surface. But these molecules which are trying to come out and get converted into gas molecules will be pushed by the atmospheric pressure. Okay. So what I have to do, if I want to come out, I have to overcome this atmospheric pressure. I have to overcome the atmospheric pressure which is acting on that. Then only whatever inside molecule is there, it will start boiling and it is getting converted into vapor. अभी ये मॉलिक्यूल्स के बाद जो इनसाइड मॉलिक्यूल्स है ना ये भी बाहर आना चाहेंगे दे वांट टू गेट कन्वर्टेड इनटू गैसेस सो इफ यू वांट टू ओवरकम दिस एटमॉस्फेरिक प्रेशर देन यू हैव टू स्टार्ट you have to get some energy, but that energy can't be achieved at 25 degrees Celsius. You know that at 25 degrees Celsius I can't boil the water unless and until I have both temperature and pressure, thermodynamic, two thermodynamic properties. These are the two properties because of which boiling can be done. Okay, now, so what I have told you, that when the temperature increases, sorry, when the pressure increases, the temperature also has to increase. Okay, on all that, clear. So to overcome this atmospheric pressure and to bring this gases molecules to the top, I have to reduce the atmospheric pressure which is acting on this. Okay, so now this is the open container in which I have placed the water. Now if I close this, okay, wait. So if I want to bring this molecules outside, what I have to do? I have to supply some additional amount of energy, that is called as heat. Okay, so to get that will increase the vapor pressure and it will get the vapors out of the this one, and it will go on, it will be in balance with the atmospheric pressure. Okay, now if I take the same water at 25 degrees Celsius in a confined space or in a closed container, in a closed container, if I take the same same water, okay, now I'll start boiling it. Before boiling it, there will be some atmospheric air which will be there on that, on the top of it, there will be some air, right? So what will happen is, when I start boiling it, the vapor molecules will start coming out, the gaseous molecules of the water vapor will start coming out, and this atmospheric air will be having some space in between it, and will start absorbing that vapor molecules. It will start giving the space to water vapor molecules. Then what will happen, these water vapor molecules will start getting saturated over here, and the atmospheric air which is there, it will be saturated completely with water vapors. Okay, water gas molecules or water vapors, right? So this water vapor molecules or vapor molecules, when they start acting a force on the container and on the liquid, on the same liquid, then that pressure, it is acting a force na, they are applying a pressure, right, to the container, to the container walls and to the same liquid, that pressure is known as vapor pressure. That pressure is known as vapor pressure. Okay, when this becomes equal to atmospheric pressure, the water will start boiling at lower temperatures also. So it means that this is the temperature line, this is the vapor pressure line. As the vapor pressure line goes on increasing, the temperature of boiling also goes on increasing. As the vapor pressure goes on decreasing, so we can boil the water at lower temperatures. Okay, this is the way water will even start boiling at the lower temperatures when the pressure inside the container goes below the vapor pressure. If it goes below the vapor pressure, even we can boil water at 20 degrees Celsius. This is called as vapor pressure. Now, there's one more thing called as cavitation. What is cavitation? Have you heard this anywhere? Cavitation generally happens in pumps, centrifugal pumps. So what happens is, there is a sump and we are connecting the pump to it. Okay, we are connecting a pump to it. Okay, so to generate the suction force, to generate the suction force from the tank or the sump, what we are going to do, we are rotating the impeller. When we rotate the impeller, the liquid is being sucked inside the impeller. Okay, so at that time, it enters into the eye of the impeller. Because of entering into the eye of the impeller, what is happening? The suction force is such a way created that it is coming from the atmospheric pressure to a lower pressure. So vacuum is created at this point. When the vacuum is created, it is tend to that the fluid will be flowing from higher pressure to lower pressure. So therefore, it will flow from atmospheric pressure to the lower pressure, right? Right. So therefore, what happens is, there is a creation of pressure, which is, there may be a creation of pressure which is below the vapor pressure. If this happens, then what will happen? The water will start boiling at normal temperature. So when it starts boiling, what will happen? It will come from the lower region to a higher region of pressure, where the higher region will be here in the blades. So when it enter into the, through the blades into the centrifugal pump, what will happen? from the lower region, that is through the lower region of pressure, the molecules or the bubbles which have been boiled because of decrease in pressure below the vapor pressure, when it comes to a higher region, higher pressure region, it will start bursting up. The bubbles will start exploding. It will explode in such a way that it will start forming cavities or holes on the blades, of the impeller or on the blades of the centrifugal pump, which will damage the pump. Okay. So it is maintained. So the pressure is maintained in such a way that it does not go below the vapor pressure. That is NPSH, net positive suction head, which we'll be studying in centrifugal pumps in turbo machine. Okay. Any doubts till now? Any doubts? Any doubts?
No, sir.
Okay. You can fine. So I have shared the notes in the last class. In the classroom. Okay.